Deep in an endangered rainforest, the hunt is on for elusive species hidden in leaf litter and rotting logs. One of the world's best known fungi photographers is at work.
I gradually became fascinated with fungi because really they're just so cool. You find them and they're just wonderful colours and wonderful shapes, and they're so transitory.
Stephen Axford first became interested in this art form 10 years ago. His stunning images of mushrooms have captivated millions of people all over the world, and especially a passionate fungi scientist in Melbourne.
Fungi are mega diverse. There's a million species at least on the planet, maybe a lot more, most of which haven't been catalogued and described. And so there's a lot of basic discovery to be done, but there's also a lot of misunderstanding about fungi. And so what Steve's doing in by capturing the fungi in the field, he's alerting people to the fact that there are these fungi out there in the forest. And he's also showing them in nature doing their stuff. So fungi are breaking down wood, they're forming symbiotic partnerships with trees and so on. So he's helping people value what they're doing.
I know people who have travelled halfway across the world just to find one of these.
One of the secrets to Axford's success is where he lives.
Oh, what's this? Blue's a very unusual colour for a fungi.
The rainforests of the New South Wales North Coast are an international hotspot for fungi, yet very little is known about the species of fungi that can be found here.
There's one in here.
Axford is passionate about finding out more.
Isn't he cute? It's a little blue light bulb.
When I first started coming out here, virtually every time I came out, I'd find something that hadn't been documented before. And one of my favourites was the blue truffle, we call it.
When Axford found this unusual mushroom, he sent specimens to Dr. Tom May at the herbarium in the Royal Botanic Gardens in Melbourne.
Well, it's a completely new species that I'd never seen before. The colour was just extraordinary. I'd never seen anything like it. Scientists who study fungi, much as we would like to be in the bush the whole time, we can't be out there all the time collecting. So all taxonomists who work on fungi are relying on collections made by field naturalists, both recently and in the past. In the 19th century, field naturalists made huge contributions collecting plants all around Australia for people like Baron von Müller. And really for fungi, we're still in that age of discovery. There's still hundreds, thousands of species out there waiting to be discovered. So anyone around Australia who spends a bit of time in the bush has a chance of coming across things and finding new species.
Today's technology has given Axford the tools to take this tradition to a whole new level. This is a shipping container which Axford fondly calls his fungarium. In it is a studio for doing time lapses of fungi.
Well, it all started with an ABC Open project for time-lapse. And I thought about doing time-lapse of clouds and landscapes and things like that, but then I thought, well, why not fungus? And I had a spare shower, which I thought the fungus would grow quite well in. So I could bring logs in and put them in the shower and the fungus would grow and I could take time-lapse. And things have just grown from there.
Well, I was just blown away when I saw the time lapses initially, because fungi are very static. It's quite hard to make a fungi exciting, apart from the colour and the form. So as soon as I saw that time lapse of the fungus growing up, shriveling back down again, tiny little insects wandering along, running up, taking a nibble, coming back down again. If you just see it in the field, you don't notice that. And also, because he's so close in, these are tiny, tiny fungi, and the insects are just even minuter. It's like it's all blown up there with movement. So it's a completely new way of seeing fungi in nature.
Fungi, unlike plants, thrive in the darkness of the forest floor.
Then the BBC came calling. Axford received an invitation from the producers of Planet Earth 2 to provide the fungi time lapses for their new David Attenborough documentary.
I never would have imagined that my photography would end up on a series that is so high profile.
But this one, as it grows, becomes luminous.
And to have David Attenborough with the voiceover on my fungi time lapse is something pretty special.
Why fungi light up has remained a mystery.
You can walk through a forest, you see the trees, you see the animals. It's very easy to overlook what's a whole kingdom of life.
Until now.
And so what Steve's doing is bringing that kingdom out in a way that's accessible to people.
Axford's time lapses and photography is also attracting the attention of international universities.
What sort of mushroom are these, Sam?
They are Amanita hemibuffa.
For the past 2 years, he's been collaborating with the Kunming Institute of Botany in China to document the fungi in the remnant rainforests of Yunnan.
It's a way to use the skills I've built up in taking photographs of fungi and have mycologists find that really useful, and I can learn heaps from them about how fungi interact with the forest and how the ecology of the whole system works. It's a wonderful way to spend your retirement.